Hello YouTube, here is a beautiful Kenwood KR-7050 that I have on sale right now on eBay and Facebook Market on the local pages. This is a, I believe from the 70s, late 70s, mid or late 70s. It's a 70 watt per channel RMS. And it's just a gorgeous, gorgeous unit. Actually one of the favorite ones I've had. When this came to me, it was in fairly rough condition, the cabinet was anyway. All the vinyl was peeling off, it was missing a couple of pieces here and there. For some reason, and I've seen it on two other Kenwoods, where the vinyl was kind of peeling away from the metal. I don't know what's up with that. It could have been heat. I don't know. Maybe you shrunk the vinyl. So anyway, I decided to redo the cabinet myself. I took the plywood apart, all the pieces apart, sanded them nice, you know, took all the vinyl off, sanded the plywood. I had to do some wood filler on some spots here and there because it was, you know, when you pull the vinyl, some of the wood comes off sometimes, even if you heat it up with a heat gun. But anyway, I chose this beautiful cherry wood veneer. This is real wood, not vinyl. And it was done the old-fashioned way, as a cabinet maker would do. I'm actually a woodworker. So it was done the old-fashioned way with contact cement, nice and sanded in the corners. And it's just, it came out really, really nice. There are no bobbles, no loose ends, no loose corners. And the color, man, the color is just amazing. I think the video does not do justice to how the aluminum, the contrast between the aluminum and the wood. It's just gorgeous. I can't imagine having chosen a different wood. It was just not being as nice as this is. That reddish brown with the aluminum is just beautiful. So anyway, that is as far as the cabinet goes. The faceplate, however, did have some flaws. This is actually a replacement that I found. The other faceplate was really not bad. It had a couple of scratches up on top somewhere around here. This one does have a nick right there. There's my fingernail for comparison. Or the tip of a key. So it is noticeable, but it's not big. And that's about it as far as the aluminum goes. With the dials, they're all in nice shape. All the knobs. Everything is in very good condition. Again, I mean, this is a unit from the 70s. And I'm actually amazed at how clean it is. You know, the glass is near perfect. There are no flaws, no cracks, no major scratches, you know, scuff marks. If you take it off to clean it, you'll see it's not brand new. But as far as the eye can tell, there are no scratches. Like what you see on the video is what you will see in person. You don't see any scratches, no scuffs, nothing. Again, if you were to take the glass off and look at it against the light, you might see the scuff marks that I'm talking about. Otherwise, you cannot see a thing. It looks just flawless and absolutely great. As far as the letters, the stencil marks, stencil letters, they're all there. There's no wear and tear to them. Nothing is fading. Everything is great. And everything works. The only thing that does not work is the FM light, and I really don't feel like taking it apart for what I'm getting for the unit. I mean, it would take me probably another hour and find it on eBay, but I got so many other things going on right now that I just don't have the time. So all the other lights work, phono, FM, everything works. I'm sorry, AM, FM does not. That's why it skips.
So it's just a bolt that needs to be replaced. Yeah, and that's as far as the way the unit looks. You know, it's just a gorgeous, like I said, gorgeous, gorgeous piece, in my opinion anyway. This one here, I did this one around the same time, I think, if I remember, and I chose mahogany for this one. And man, I almost wish I would have done it the same way with that cherry wood. It just, it didn't bring out the brush aluminum phase as good as the, well, this is actually brushed stainless. But the metalwork does not look as it doesn't pop out as much as with the cherry. That color is just amazing. So anyway, tell you what was done with this unit is this cluster right here, which is a three unit cluster, three button cluster. I had to replace because this guy here was missing on the one that I had. So I was lucky enough to find another faceplate, and I was able to replace it. So now it's complete. All the other buttons are there. Everything does work. So I'm gonna take a couple of minutes now and take it through its paces and go from there. Hopefully I won't miss anything. I'm gonna have to play some music, you know, make some noise. The speakers that I have, and please forgive my mess here in my shed. That is all I have right now hooked to it. It's a pair of Ohms E2. I believe they're 60 watt max. So, you know, I can't really crank it up too much because they just won't handle the power. And I don't want to screw them up. They're really hard to find. So, anyhow, I'm going to get going here with a CD that I have. I believe that's Tom Petty CD.
She's a good girl, loves her mama, loves Jesus in America too. She's a good girl. Crazy,
yeah, your balance,
loves horses,
left channel,
and her boyfriend too.
Right channel.
And it's a long day, living in
sleep. There's your EQ. Again, everything works as you should. Your turnover for the bass. Tone button works. Hey, filter. And your loudness.
And all the bad boys standing in the shack.
Speaker. Obviously, I only have one set of speakers connected to it, so that's what you get. And you can see that it's receiving the signal, but obviously not sending it to the speakers because of the bypass. All right, let's try FM. Again, I'm not gonna get a whole lot here because reception is terrible where I am. So you're not gonna hear a whole lot. But you get the idea. You're not gonna be able to see the stereo light come on because I get like almost no signal here. Huh, maybe a light. There you go. Right there. I don't have an antenna hooked up to this thing. It's just a couple of speaker wires that I have on. But that is it. And that is your AM. Now here, I don't think we're going to grab anything. Yeah, there's really nothing there. Going back to this guy here. Tape. There you go. As that goes, and now we go to phono. Basically it. Again, I think I show you guys everything. That's just a mono and stereo. That's pretty much it. That's the gist of it. Let me turn this thing off. So that is for your consideration. It is a Kenwood KR-7050. You can find any information on these units on the web. Again, one light is missing or out, which is the FM light. Everything else works. At some point, somebody did LED replacement lights for the dial, and they are very dim. I don't know why. It's another thing I don't want to mess with. If I end up keeping the unit later on, I will probably tinker with that. But that's it. I hope you enjoyed it, and hit me up if you're interested in any more information on the Kenwood. I will have on the listing on eBay, which is under JKU. I'm sorry, NJJKU, that's my username. You will find pictures of the back of the unit, I believe some of the inside, and as well as the sides and maybe the bottom. So the unit is in near perfect condition. Any questions, please let me know. Thank you.